In today's video, I will talk about how I reached SHD rank 1000 so fast, what are the best and most efficient way to rank up your SHD watch, how the SHD watch works, what to spec, and what you get when you hit 1000 with the watch. If that sounds interesting, then let's get started. So my main focus recently have been the SHD watch, and I finally reached the rank 1000. So with this video, I thought I would tell you guys how I did it and what are some good ways to actually level it up. So the most efficient way to level your SHD watch up is to do the target practice. So the target practice is one of these green activities, which will appear on the map when you do own some control points. The more control points you own, the more of them will spawn. The best area is this one right here, which is downtown east. But if you actually own a lot of the control points, like most of them on the map, they will spawn like crazy all over the map. So you go and do one target practice, and when you're done with that, you still have multiples to do. So you can basically do them non-stop, which is super efficient in terms of experience. It's super easy to do, but it is a bit boring, but it does reward really good experience. So to get the most out of the shooting range, you want to have the global difficulty on heroic. You also want to put on all the directives, because that gives you additional 125%. And since with the target practice, you only fight target practice, right, and no NPCs, those modifiers doesn't matter, but they will in fact increase the experience you get from the activity. So since I refreshed the map now, I'm not sure if we will still see it on the map. We probably have to wait for that. And yeah, my map is not that good looking. As you know, I'm pretty lazy when it comes to fixing the map, right? So I usually just join my friends. But here we have one shooting practice though. So 329k experience. And then we have the experience boost as well. So let's just go here quickly and I can show you how this is done. So the more control points you have cleared on the map, the more they will spawn. So in a perfect scenario, you want to have all of them captured. If you have a friend that have a lot of them captured, you can just use his session. That's what I mainly did. But right now, it's only me online. So yeah, we got my session here, which is definitely not good enough for this. But hey. So here we are at the target practice. Just go and talk to him. Just go into position, and it's time to practice your aim. So you just hit them like this. It's four different rounds. If you fail, you can still go and redo it. You will actually get experience for that. However, that's nothing that I do. I just finish them. And yeah, because if you start finishing them and all that, it kind of turns into you abusing the game, right? And that's not what we want to do. We just want to do the activity. Because doing the activities like this, it's just how the game works. It's just the fact that the target practice itself gives you too much experience. That's the reason why it's so good, right? So then now we did it and we got basically a half a rank just from that. We also get the loot target loot as well. So if you look at the map, this one drops Araldi. So we get one piece of Araldi every time. Then you would do that and you would have some more control points on the map here. You would look. And you would just teleport. But as you can see, my map is terrible for that. If you don't have a friend, then just go and clear the control points on the map. The more control points you have, the more they're gonna spawn. So anyway, personally, I would not recommend to do this though. It's really efficient, but it's really, really boring. And I mean, unless you really, really want to reach 1000 SHD, like it's not that important, right? But anyway, I thought I would show you the best way and how I did it basically. But yeah, there's also two other options that are really, really good. One of them being Dark Zone. And I understand a lot of you guys don't like Dark Zone, but it's just really, really good. And I do have another one for you guys that hate Dark Zone. So yeah, you could just skip this part, I guess. But definitely, I would recommend to try Dark Zone because it's super efficient in terms of experience. It's easy and you also get good loot. So let me tell you why though. So Dark Zone is scaled for 2 players. And the difficulty on the NPCs in here is actually super low compared to the other parts of the game. If you look at the heroic one here, you can see it gives you 660,000 experience, which basically is one SHD rank. So when you play in Dark Zone, you want to make sure you are in the invaded one because they give more experience. The other twos give less. So if you want to do it for experience, get to invaded. When you're in there, you want to go for all the heroic landmarks as soon as you can. Because they give the most experience. If you don't have any heroic, then go and do a challenging. Gives 495,000. And if there's no challenging ones, then yeah, of course, go for hard. But even running a long bit to get to the heroic one, it's definitely worth. Like, I even been doing this solo for a little bit, and it's still pretty damn good. But definitely recommend you to 4-man this. If you can't do that, then maybe 2-man. Just try to matchmake it, but if you don't have any people to play with, and you really, really hate Darkzone because the rogues and they can steal your loot, then sure, don't do this. If you go in with the right mindset and you really want to up your SHD rank, it's a really good way. But keep in mind, everything you loot in here, it's not yours until you hit the extraction, put it on, and it's actually in your stash. I think if you have that mindset and you're also prepared to get ganked, you're gonna have a way better time. But I think that basically covers the Darkzone route though. Then we have the third alternative, which is pretty damn good as well. And that's just open world activities. So right now you can't reset the control point, sadly, which they said would be a thing, but I guess it's bugged. So you can't do all the control points on the map, but something that's actually better is just to do the side activities that are tied to the control point. So if you don't clear a control point, let's say you don't clear this control point right here, and you only do the side activities here, they're gonna respawn all the time. So you can just farm them. And if you look at this one, it gives you 329k experience. So same as the shooting range. So basically half a level per activity. If you really want to though, you can do the control points. And when... Okay, I got disconnected. Feels bad, man.
Press space to start.
Did service go down again? Okay, so I just got DC there, so I kind of lost myself. But anyway, where were we? Control points. So you want to do the side activities. Something that you could do though is to clear the control points, which are pretty good, right? You would get some experience that way. And when you cleared all of them and they are all green, then you could do the shooting range for a bit to mix it up. And then you could go back and do the control points, or maybe reset the session and do some world activities for the control points, right? And then even swap in some dark zone. Because doing shooting range only, it's really, really boring. But if you mix it up a bit, you're gonna have a better time. I did a lot of shooting range recent week, but I would do a few hours here and then I would take a break from the game and come back and do it. Sometimes mix in some invaded Darkzone. Like, invaded Darkzone is great and I really do love that. So that's probably what I personally would recommend. But if you don't like Darkzone, the open world is a great alternative. And especially if you look at the loot target map, there's so many zones here. So let's say I want to farm Overlord for the knee pad. You could just do this one right here. But if you want to farm Petrov, you can do control point activities here as well. So pretty good for the loot targeting. And of course, when it comes to the open world activities as well, the way I did it is to do it on heroic with four directives, excluding the special ammo. It's not worth to have that. It's only 25% and special ammo is real annoying. So that's how I would play it. If you can't manage it on heroic with the directives, then sure, lower it to maybe challenge, but that's just how I did it. But yeah, I think that covers the open world activities. I did actually have a script for this, but I might have missed something here. So if you have any questions about Darkzone or target practice or the open world activities, feel free to put that in the comment section below and I will answer that. But let's actually get to the watch though. So I crashed, but I'm actually back. So let's check out the watch here. So how do you get the watch though? So I guess spoiler alert here, you need to have Warlords of New York expansion. When you clear the last mission, you do get the watch from Keener. It's called Keener's Watch. And then you progress it every time you level up in the top right corner, which we can't see now because I'm in the base though. But you used to get a field proficiency cash every time you leveled up after the max level. Now you do get a SHD rank point. So every time you rank up, you will be able to put points into these different categories. So one rank will give you one offensive. And when you rank up to 2, you get 1 point in defensive. When you hit rank 3, you get 1 in handling and so on. So if you would hit rank 6, for example, you would have 2 points in offensive, 1 in defensive, 1 in handling, 1 in scavenging, and 1 in utility. So we can take a look at the different trees here, and I will tell you what I think is the best way to spec and also how I spec'd it. And we can also see the values you get from them when they are maxed out. So looking at the offensive tree, I would start off with weapon damage. It is the best stat you can get here. So yeah, 10% weapon damage is what you get at max. So when you do hit 250 SHD level, you will have 50 points, which means you can max out 1 in each category. So 10% weapon damage, which is pretty strong. Then after that, I would go for critical hit chance, which is 10%. And this just feels so nice to get 10% crit chance completely free. Then after that, there's critical hit damage and headshot damage. I actually expect headshot damage though, but I think for most people, you probably want to go critical hit damage. But anyway, headshot damage, it's actually 20%, so pretty big value. And critical hit damage is 20% as well. So I mean, that's quite a lot of extra stats you get from leveling up the watch. Which in my opinion, I think it's a little bit too much stats that you get. However though, like leveling up to 1000, it does take a lot of time though. But if you focus on it and you are efficient, you will be able to hit it way faster than they expected, I'm sure of that. I just don't think they expected us to hit it this fast though. Then we go to defensive. Go for total armor first. You get 10% extra armor. Pretty damn good. After that, I actually went for hazard protection, 10%. Then I think I went health, which is 10% as well. And then explosive resistance, 10% as well. We go to handling. I started off with actually a mix of accuracy and reload speed. But I would recommend you to go reload speed, which is 10%. But I love to decrease the bloom, so after that, I went accuracy. And then I went actually stability. And then last, ammo capacity. I don't think ammo capacity is that important, right? So that's what I did. Then we have scavenging, which is just materials and credits. I haven't claimed any reward at all here. I'm just saving them for when I really need them. Because you can just stack them up here. So I have 201 scavenging points I can use. So yeah, you can see I'm above some caps here, so there's no reason for me to use it. So I just keep it here for whenever I need a lot of them. And also worth noting though, when you hit SHD level 1000, you will get 3 HP per SHD rank. And you also will get a scavenging point every single rank up. So that's good to know. Then we have utility. I started with skill haste, definitely the one you want to go here, most likely 10%. Then after that, it's a bit more up to you. I would either go skill repair or skill damage, depending on your build. I think I went skill repair actually, and then skill damage, and lastly skill duration. So that's where I put in my points when I leveled SHD watch. But I think a lot of the stats you get, you can just choose whatever you want. I think like weapon damage and crit chance, it's important to go in that order. And same with defensive one, to go total armor first though. Other than that, it doesn't matter too much. But yeah, I mean, that's a lot of extra stats you're getting. And I mean, so getting like 10 crit chance, that's like one brand set of Siska, for example. Getting 20 headshot damage, that's bigger than any of the brand set bonus. I mean, when you think about it, the watch is actually pretty damn insane. Like getting 20 critical hit damage as well, that's better than Providence 3-piece, so... Definitely a lot of stats you do get. I think it's a little bit too strong, but at the same time, I don't think they expected us to hit it this fast. So yeah, would be interesting to see what you guys think about this. But I think we're gonna conclude the video here. Hopefully I managed to get everything into this video that I wanted. I did make a script, but honestly there's so much text there, and I thought I would just do it on the go anyway. So next time, I don't even think I do a script. I will just have some keywords, because I personally like that more, and it gives the video a bit more flow than comparing it to reading a script. But anyway, thank you guys for watching this video. And if you are interested in more Division 2 videos, then make sure to hit that subscribe button. And I also want to give a shout out to my YouTube members. We actually hit 50 members today, so I guess that's the first milestone for the YouTube membership. I definitely do want to start doing more stuff with the YouTube membership. Currently what I'm doing right now, I think I have some members post, and I let you guys ask questions with your builds or any Division 2 related questions, and I answer them as fast as I can. Of course I do that stuff as well on YouTube comments and outside of YouTube and all that, but I get a lot of comments and PMs, so at least the YouTube membership, it's easier for me to keep track of, and especially having everything in one spot. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed the video, and see you guys in the next one.